Technology.
It shapes
and reshapes our world.
The hardware and the software
make us aware of better ways of doing things.
For work or for leisure, technology can improve our lives
and re-energize our lifestyles.
We can create it
or we can adapt it.
The technology of the present can help us prepare
for a future perfect.
Hi, I'm Tony Velasquez. Some drivers get the urge to play Need for Speed in real-life highways, thinking overspeeding is a cool thing to do. But the Metro Manila Development Authority has since stepped up its own game. It's taking a firmer stance on enforcing a 60 km/h speed limit along Commonwealth Avenue. Now, here's how authorities are speed reading Quezon City's drivers.
Speeding can be exciting on the track. Speeding can be amusing in cartoons. And speeding can be mind-boggling if you're the $6 billion man. But speeding in a car on a main city road can be fatal. Or if you do it along Quezon City's killer highway, the Commonwealth Avenue, it could soon lead to having your license revoked. On January 25, the Metro Manila Development Authority, or MMDA, began enforcing a 60 km/h speed limit along Commonwealth Avenue. At the time, the MMDA had to rely on speed radar guns it borrowed from the Manila North Tollways Corporation. Since then, the MMDA has acquired its own speed guns. But instead of radar, the MMDA is using Lidar, or light detection and ranging. Specifically, the MMDA chose to use the US-made LTI 2020 TrueCam.
This is used in, I think, over 28 countries. It's one of the cheapest guns you can buy, because there's some, like the one from NLEX, I think they got it at almost $70,000, and this one is below $10,000. But you might think that it sounds expensive from the start, but imagine the amount of lives that you're gonna save. I mean, how much is a human life? So if, you know, with one of these you save 10, 20 lives,
it's worth it.
Future Perfect asked MMDA spokesman Yves, Gonzalez to demonstrate and explain the TrueCam's capabilities in nighttime and daytime traffic conditions along a stretch of Commonwealth Avenue. Yves says the TrueCam LiDAR is carefully adjusted each day to ensure accurate speed measurements.
What we have to do is every day, before we start deployment, we have to calibrate it. And then at the end of the day as well, after the shift of the enforcers, they have to calibrate it as well, so that we can be sure that every day the measurements are accurate.
From a high vantage point on Commonwealth, such as a footbridge, an MMDA traffic enforcer can easily observe a speeding vehicle and target it with a TrueCam.
With a Lidar, you actually target a particular vehicle, yeah. And he's the kumbaga, speed lang niya yung na-re-record mo and no one else. Plus, it's recorded on video. Plus, at a certain point, it's recorded as a photo.
Okay.
So, there's a video and a photo combination. So, talagang it's a, you can't dispute it. We use the radar on motorbikes as well, because, but we shoot them from behind because the plate number is at the back.
Yeah.
So, spotter will say there's an incoming motorbike approaching, and then the guy will point it in the other direction so that he can actually get the plate.
It's easy enough for the TrueCam to take clear video and still images of overspeeding vehicles and their plate numbers during the daytime. But Yves demonstrated how it can just as efficiently do that at night.
Well, maybe people are going to wonder why we're actually trying this at night instead of daytime.
Well, of course, most of the accidents in Commonwealth happen at night when when the bus drivers feel that there's no longer anyone watching. So what we're doing now is we actually have night deployment now here in Commonwealth to actually enforce discipline here in Commonwealth.
To make sure the TrueCam was tracking vehicle speeds accurately, we also tested it on a vehicle outfitted with a GPS navigation system that displays its ground speed. A comparison of the GPS speed indicator and the TrueCam's own speed reading showed the Lidar to be highly accurate.
Yung driver mo, in-instructa natin na tumakbo ng 70. Tapos nagabit tayo ng GPS GPS dun sa sasakyan para makita nyo yung actual speed. So yung unang takbo ng driver mo, nahuli natin siya at 67. Tapos yung pangalawang ikot, sakto 70. 70 natin mismo na hula kasi syempre hindi naman consistent yung ano niya.
A still image and video clip of an overspeeding vehicle along with other pertinent data such as the speed reading and the time and location of the violation is recorded by the TrueCam on an SD card. The images can be downloaded later into any computer with the TrueCam software installed on it.
In the TrueCam application, you can then generate a screenshot. And then it'll be the one to actually input the values.
Okay.
So there's no way that an operator can manipulate the value,
yeah,
except if you Photoshop it. But of course, if you Photoshop it, you can easily get caught because Photoshop leaves a mark.
The pictures recorded by the TrueCam LiDAR will serve as evidence of a motorist speeding violation that will be sent to him in the form of a summons.
Merong traffic adjudication board. So you will receive a summons. Within 7 days, you will have to explain bakit ka nag-overspeeding, explain mo. So kung maja-justify mo naman na mag-aatid ka ng pasyente sa ospital, magdadala ka ng anak sa school na ganito-ganito, so yun yung bibigyan ka ng due process sa Traffic Adjudication Board.
So motorists on Commonwealth Avenue, beware. Your speed will soon be tracked with LiDAR. And if you're not careful, you might just get hit with a 1,200 peso fine and for three-time violators with a revocation of your driver's license. You might outrun the roadrunner, but you can't lie to the LiDAR.
And joining us here on Future Perfect is the MMDA Assistant General Manager, Emerson Carlos. Thank you, sir, for coming.
Thank you. Good evening.
And also with us, the agency supervising consultant, Yves Gonzalez. Hello, Yves, and thank you for that lengthy demonstration both during the daytime and the nighttime of the LiDAR. And you changed outfits, sir. Talagang napaka-fashionable mo kasi while we're doing the LiDAR test along Commonwealth. AGM, you know, I wonder how motorists are, of course, reacting to, you know, the news that the MMDA will enforce the 60 kilometer per hour speed limit. We saw, of course, Chairman Francis Tolentino explaining how the speed limit rule will be enforced and how the summons will be given. I remember reading a report, and I don't know if this is accurate, that there are already about 2,000 or over 2,000 apprehensions made. Totoo ba yun?
Yes, correct. That's almost 2,000 apprehensions made. I sign almost 200 TBRs every day.
Wow.
For this particular, just for Commonwealth alone.
Just for Commonwealth alone.
Yes.
And that was since the speed limit was enforced?
Yes.
Mm. So we're talking about the period after January 25 onwards, no?
Onwards.
And how were they caught? I mean, what were you using? You weren't using the LiDAR yet.
We were using the LiDAR as well as our video cameras.
Uh-huh.
And after these are downloaded to our servers,
mm-hmm,
we print the summons and we serve them to the bus companies or the private vehicles.
Okay. Of the 200 TVRs that you sign, anong percentage doon ang mga PUVs, buses, or jeeps?
Of course, there are a lot of PUVs.
Mostly.
Mostly there are PUVs, actually buses.
Yeah.
They comprise almost around 70% of those apprehended.
Okay. And the summons are served through email or through mail?
No, we serve them through we have a courier,
mm-hmm,
and they would receive the summons a day after I sign this summons.
Okay.
And they have to respond within 7 days.
Mm-hmm.
Either they contest it or they should pay the fine.
All right. And of the TVRs that you've delivered through courier, how many of them have actually contested the summons?
So far, I have not heard of any contested summons.
Mm. Because the Chairman Francis Tolentino, as we heard in the report, was talking about a traffic adjudication board. No? They have to face that adjudication board within 7 days after they receive the summons. Who's manning the traffic adjudication board?
Traffic adjudication board is manned by our lawyers in the legal service, and they adjudicate any complaint or any protest on these summons.
Okay, and this is within the MMDA's office, no?
Yes, correct.
In Guadalupe. Meron bang nakapag-defend sa kanila, sa sarili nila na no, we were not overspeeding and they were let off the hook?
So far, we have not heard of any contest in this summons.
Because you documented them with your own equipment?
Yes, we have documented them precisely with our equipment, and this is a very good piece of evidence that's very difficult to contest.
Ika nga nung aking kaibigan, hindi nagsisinungaling ang ebidensya. Okay, but I'm not going to dance like him. Hindi showtime to it. Yves, of course, we've had a very lengthy demonstration already of its capabilities, the LIDAR, how it can be used during the day and how it can also be used at night. We want you to just give us a cursory look at the different parts of the TrueCam LIDAR.
Okay, so at the top we have the scope. This is where you actually look through and find your target. And then in the front we have the two. This is the light. This is the one that emits the light, and this is the one that catches it, so that it can determine how long it took for the pulse of light to